Hello everyone, welcome to EditUp. So in today's session, we are going to do a very interesting topic that is about the business cycle. So in this session, we will discuss about the phases of the business cycle and we will discuss about the variables that are affected in the business cycle. So before starting with the topic, please subscribe to our YouTube channel if you are new to the channel and join our Telegram channel for the PDF of this session. And you can get the link of the Telegram channel in the description box below. So here you can see the business cycle. In the Y-axis we are taking, in the X-axis we are taking the time that is measured in the years, and in the y-axis we are taking the real GDP, that is the value of the goods and services that are produced in the economy. Okay, how is it different from the nominal GDP? Because in this, in the real GDP, we do not include the inflation, and so the real GDP tells us the actual value of the goods that are produced in the economy. So now, as you can see here, there is a smooth or continuous upward sloping curve. So what this curve is, okay, this is the long run growth trend curve. That is, if we compare our country of the 1947 with the country with India of 2021, there is a huge difference. The healthcare system has changed. The education, there are so many education institutions that have came as new. Okay, so there is a huge difference between the country India of the 1947 and the India of the 2021. And we have seen a long journey of the continuous growth in the long run. Okay, as well as the population of the country has increased, due to which the production, the real GDP, the production or the actual value of the goods and services has also increased. And with the increase in the population, and we wanted to do more production, so we have also created many new technologies to help us in the journey of the growth. With the increase in the technologies, the productivity of the workers has also increased, because we are working in with huge machines now, and so the productivity of the workers has also increased, and this helps in the continuous growth and the increase in the real GDP, that is in the increase of the actual production that is happening in the country. So the productivity has also increased and the labor force participation has also increased. Okay, so this is the all about that, how we have seen the long run growth, because the population has increased, with which the production has also increased, because the new population needs the consumption, needs to do consumption, have some demands. So with that, the technologies and the productivity has also increased, and that has helped in the real GDP growth, continuous growth in the long run. But can we say that we have seen a smooth path of growth in the short run also? No. In the short run, there is much up and down that can be seen in the economy. And not only in India, but in every economy of the world, there is up and down that happens in the short run. So here, as we can see that there are four phases, okay? We have divided the business cycle into the four phases. The first one we can say is the peak. That is the highest GDP, highest real GDP that we can attain in the short run is the peak. And the lowest GDP that we can go, lowest real GDP that we can go in the short run is the trough. Then from the peak to the trough comes the contraction. When we have reached the highest GDP, then we will contract. We will go down, because now we cannot go above that. We cannot go above the peak. So where we will go? We will go down. So we will contract. Then we will reach the lowest point and we cannot go beneath that. So there will be some external forces that will help us to expand. So there we reach to the expansion phase, and again we will keep on expanding and we will reach the peak. After that we will not be able to grow, so we will come down. In the now, from the peak to trough, as I told you, this is the contraction phase. This is the contraction phase. And here, as you can see, the contraction phase is divided into the recession and the depression. And the from the trough to the peak, there is the expansion phase. Expansion phase is also divided into two categories. The recovery is happening and then there is a boom that is there. So I hope you have understood the business cycle very easy. From the peak, you cannot go above, so you go down. So the country will go down and will contract and reach to the minimum point. And after that, it will again start expanding and will reach to the peak. So this is a continuous process that keeps on happening in the short run. Now, as I told you that I will also tell you the variables that are in these in these phases that is happening. So take an example that technological growth has happened. There is a technological revolution that has happened. So the productivity of the people has increased. Now the consumers, the producers are happy and they know that their income will keep on increasing and they will have a long-term permanent income because their productivity has increased. So they will have the confidence and the positivity has, the optimism in the country has increased. Take another example that the government that has come, the new government that has come is a very good government and it has brought so many good policies for the consumers and the producers. So the demand of the consumers will increase because the consumers are very confident, because the consumers are very happy. And with the increase in the demand, the production will also increase. With this increase in the production, the employment will increase because the producers will employ the workers to increase the production. So the employment will increase, the investment will also increase. And when the employment increases, again the demand will increase because new people are getting employed. Those people will also demand something. So the demand will again increase and this cycle will go on. This is the expansion phase. This is the phase where the country is expanding. Okay. So all the variables are increasing in this phase. Now you will reach a peak that you have expanded. In the short run, you have grown so much. So there will be a point that you have reached the peak. Now maybe due to the stock market crash, because there many people, now they were so happy that we have seen the continuous growth. When we are investing in the stock market, our money is getting doubled because the industries are keep on growing. So maybe they will keep on investing and misallocating the investments, due to which now the economy has stopped growing and the stock market will crash, and so the economy will see a downturn. Take another thing, that the full employment, in the peak there will be a full employment. Okay, because resources are not infinite. Okay, there will be a moment when in the short run the full employment will be reached. The land is fixed, the land cannot grow. The agricultural output will also be fixed. The workers are fixed. There is a full employment that has been reached. Okay. And remember that in the short run, the technology cannot grow in one day. The technology needs time. The productivity needs time to increase. So in the short run, the full employment is being reached. And so we have reached the peak. And after that, the economy will go down because due to the full employment now, the production cannot happen and the demand is too huge. The demand is being continuously going up and going up and going up. So after that, when we reach the full employment, the demand will go down, because in the full employment, when the demand is so high, that the hyperinflation will come because the producers are not able to produce. And so after that, the demand, seeing the hyperinflation, the demand will go down, and with the demand going down, the production will go down, the employment will go down, the investment will go down in the country, and so we will see the contraction. And first the recession will come, and after this recession, if the demand is continuously going down, then we will see the depression also, and the economy will reach a trough. After that, we cannot go more down, because at least there must be some minimum consumption. Now we all need food, we all need some clothes, so there will be still the minimum consumption that is happening. And after that, due to some external force, maybe there is new invention, maybe there is a new technology that has been found after that. So maybe due to the new invention, maybe the government is trying to boost the economy, maybe the government is trying to bring the new policies that is helpful. So after that, the economy will again start expanding, where they will see again all the variables going up. In the expansion phase, the variables have a positive outlook, it goes up, and there is a positive optimism wave that is going on in the country. When the recession, depression, and when the contraction is happening, all the variables go down because the people do not have the optimistic wave. There is a pessimistic wave that is going on. And as I told you, when we are going up, when we reach the peak, there is full employment, the demand is too high at that time, and the producers cannot cater to that high demand because the resources are not infinite. Okay, so after that, the curve go down. I hope you have understood this. Now thank you so much. If you have any query, you can mail us here or you can contact us through this number. Thank you very much.